Hello all. Welcome to your lesson 2 of Innovation and Strategic Formulation. We are going to talk about your analyzing the external environment of the firm and creating competitive advantages. So we are already in chapter 2. So if you have a book, most likely this is the chapter 2 of your topic already. If you have strategic management books, okay? Now, we are on the external environment already. All right, so what are our learning objectives for this session? Number one, it is to explain the importance of analyzing and understanding the firm's external environment. Next is to define and describe the general environment and the industry environment. So we will be tackling that later on. Next is to discuss the four activities of the external environment analysis process. We will name and describe the general environment and its seven segments. We also have here the identification of the five competitive forces and explanation on how they determine the industry's profit potential. We are also going to define the strategic groups and describe their influence on the firm and describe the firm's need to know about the competitors and the different methods used to collect intelligence about them. Okay? Let us start by having some of your important definitions. A firm's external environment is broken down into three parts. You have your general environment, industry, and your competitor, okay? But in some of your references, this is only broken down into two. You have your general environment and your competitive environment, which is composed of your industry and your competitor, okay? So you have your general environment and your competitive environment, okay? A firm's strategic action are influenced by this condition, meaning you have to take into consideration your general environment, your industry, and your competitor. Now, what is your general environment? When you say general environment, those are the factors that are external to an industry, and they are usually beyond the firm's control and affect the firm's strategy. So what are your keywords here? Okay, they are external. External to the industry. So if you try to notice, your general environment is part of the macro. Okay? Your industry and competitor environment is part of your micro. Again, we go back to your general. It is beyond the firm's control. So another keyword here is beyond firm's control. So these are one of your uncontrollable items if you have to take these parts or these items into consideration in creating your strategy. Okay? Meaning, among all the factors, ito yung hindi mo makokontrol. Meaning, nandyan na yan, it is inherent on your presence or on your environment as well. When you talk about the industry, this is a group of firms that produce similar goods or services. Okay? So, sila, nandun sila sa part ng competitor mo. Or actually, your competitor environment, it is or it can be part of your industry environment. And of course, if you talk about your competitor environment or competitive environment, these are the factors that pertain to an industry and affect the firm's strategy, meaning there is a direct competition under your competitor environment. Now, we have here more of your external environment. You have here the different general environment. So this environment is under your general environment. Number one, you have your demographic segment. Okay? When you talk about demographic segment, you have your genetic and observable characteristic of a population. Okay? It includes the level and growth of age, density, sex, race, ethnicity, education, geographic region, and income. That is your demographics, okay? I think we also have it here on our PowerPoint presentation. It is on the next slides. There. Again, it is on your general environment. So under your general environment, these are the items that you have to take into consideration so that you can successfully deal with uncertainty of your external environment. And of course, to achieve strategic competitiveness. So again, let us review. Let's start with your demographics. So ito yung sinabi ko kanina, tama ba, about the control? These are, I mean, about general environment, these are the items that the firm cannot directly control. However, these segments influence the action that the firms take. It is correct. And of course, the company should learn how to manage and how to identify implications so that they can successfully strategize. I have mentioned already the demographic, so it is here. What is included in your demographic is the population size, age structure, geographic distribution, ethnic mix, and income distribution. Ano pa yung iba ko nasabi kanina? You have education, geographic region, income. So, kasama na dun yung income distribution. What else? You have your ethnicity, race, the gender or the sex, of course, the density, and the level of growth of age. The next group, you have your economic segment. For the economic segment, it is talking about the characteristic of the economy, including national income and monetary condition. And of course, not only that, you also have here your inflation, interest rate, trade deficits and surpluses. You have your budget deficit and surplus, personal saving rate, business saving, domestic or gross domestic product. Again, it refers to the nature and direction of the economy in which the company is competing. Okay, that is your economic segment in terms of your general environment. Next, we go to your political or legal segment. For the political and legal segment, this is showing how a society creates and exercises power, including rules, laws, and taxation policies. So, tinutukoy nito yung mga legal items natin, specifically the law, yung mga policies in the environment where the company is operating. Okay? You have here your antitrust law, taxation law, other deregulation philosophy, you have your labor and training law, and educational philosophies and policies. So, those are also affecting the strategy of a company. Next, you have your socio-cultural. For the socio-cultural, these are items that are talking about your values, the beliefs, the lifestyle of a society. Okay, it is concerned with the society's attitudes and cultural values. So, anong kasama dyan? Let us say the women in workforce. Okay, your workforce itself. You have the diversity of the attitudes about the quality of work life. Okay. Next, you have your shift in work and career preferences, like anong work ba yung gusto nila, or what type of industry they wanted to work, or what type of career, or how do they want their career to progress. Next is the shift in product and service. Let us say, initially, gusto nila ng facial wash. Ngayon, hindi na pala facial wash. Gusto niya na lang is facial cleansers, yung mga yan. What are the different preferences, di ba? Not only those, there are a lot of examples that we can have. Let us say, you prefer initially, you want Nike, di ba? Pero ngayon, gusto mo na mag-ASICS, di ba? That's part of your shift of product and service preferences. That's part of your socio-cultural segment, which you have to take into consideration if you create strategy. Next part of your general environment is technological segment. For the technological segment, these are talking about, or this is about, the innovation and state of knowledge in industrial arts. You have your engineering, applied sciences, and pure science and their interaction with the society. Okay? In short, it's all about your different sciences as well as your technological changes. What are these? You have your product innovation, new communication technologies, pumasok dyan yung, ano ba yung mga new communication technologies? Sa cellphone mo dati, wireless. Pero yung wireless na yan, di ba, magkadikit pa yung earphones mo. Ngayon, yung bagong produkto ni Apple, you have your AirPods. Is that correct? O di ba, wala na siyang wire totally. Bluetooth na lang talaga siya or what connection that code is, okay, or that is code. Next, you have your application of knowledge and of course, focus of private and government supported R&D expenditures. So, pumapasok na din dyan ngayon sa strategies ng government natin, yung mga changes in technologies and sciences. Next is your global segment. When you talk about your global segment, these are the influences from foreign countries, including foreign market opportunities, foreign-based competition, and expanded capital markets. Okay? Anong kasama dyan? You have your important political events. You have your critical global markets, newly industrialized countries, and different cultural and institutional attributes. So when you talk about global segments, ito naman yung tumutukoy sa mga foreign items natin or foreign factors. Let us say, meron ba tayong market outside the country? What are the different preferences that they have? Okay? Or ano yung mga trends ngayon? Let us say, meron kang market in USA. Diba? Initially, dito ka lang sa Philippines. Meron ka ngayon branch sa USA. Now, dahil nag-branch out ka sa USA, pag-aralan mo ano ba yung trend doon. Diba? In this specific product that we have, how can we sell it na it goes with the trend or with the fab in the USA? So that's what you talk about or yun yung kailangan mong i-consider when you talk about global segments under your general environment. Next is of course your physical environment segment. When you talk about physical environment segment, this is concerned with trends oriented to sustaining the world's physical environment. Kung ano yung nakikita mo, literal, di ba? Anong na-observe natin? It can be social, it can be economic, that can be ecological, okay? Or that can be physical per se. And of course, kasama dyan, or one of the examples is your energy consumption, the different practices of your energy sources. You have your energy efforts, minimizing the firm's environmental footprint. So, kung mapapansin mo, kadalasan nung sa physical environment segment is more on your environmental concerns. Of course, your availability of water as a resource, producing environmental friendly product, kaya nauso si eco bag, and reacting to natural or man-made disasters. Meron pa ba under the general segment? So, you have also the physical environment. Meron lang siyang sample dito. So, a firm's effort to take care of a physical environment in which they compete. Nandito yung mga program, let's say, ni McDonald's, ni Procter & Gamble. Diyan dumating yung mga items that is talking about your corporate social, tama ba? Corporate social responsibility. Kasi para mas matangkilik yung product nila, dapat we give back to the environment. Okay? So kaya nauso yung paper cups, pati yung straw ngayon, paper straw na, di ba? Ang hirap inumin. So dapat ubusin mo na kagad yung milk tea mo or yung frap mo. Ayan. Frap, frappe, whatever. Okay. Next is your external environment analysis. For the external environment, you have your turbulent, complex, global, uncertain, and ambiguous, incomplete items. So, for the firms engage in external environment analysis so that they can cope up with the changes and they can understand the current situation so that they know how they can strategize. Now, dito papasok si scanning, monitoring, forecasting, and assessing. Okay? Now, what is the role of your scanning, monitoring, competitive intelligence, and forecasting? So do we have it here? So for the scanning, environmental scanning, what you do here is surveillance of firm's external environment to predict environmental changes and detect changes already under the way. Okay? That is your scanning. How about your monitoring? You are trying to detect meaning through ongoing observation, meaning you are or the firm is analyzing the external environment that tracks evolution of environmental trends, sequences of events, or streams of activity. That is what you call your monitoring, or that's the purpose of your monitoring. How about your forecasting? The environmental forecasting, it is here where the development of plausible projection about direction, scope, speed, and the intensity of environmental change happens. So, dun mo makikita yon. You do forecasting, meaning you develop plausible projection. Again, you develop projections. Okay? How about your assessing? Okay? Sa assessment naman, or sa analysis, you have here an in-depth approach to environmental forecasting, which involves detailed assessment. So, you have here a detailed assessment of the societal trends, economics, politics, technology, and other dimensions of the external environment. Okay? Again, that is a detailed assessment of the social or societal trends. What else? Ang bilis ko magsulat, ang pangit tuloy. You have your economic, you have your politics, you have your technology. Okay? And of course, other dimensions of your external environment. Whatever factors that you can analyze. Your assessing is also called your scenario analysis. Okay? Your assessing part is also called your scenario analysis. What else? Meron pang kulang. You have your competitive intelligence, your CI, or your competitive intelligence. Ayan. Your competitive intelligence is a firm's activities of collecting and interpreting data on competitors. And you are defining and understanding the industry and identifying competitor strengths and weaknesses. So dito sa competitive intelligence, you are analyzing not only the industry, but you are analyzing your competitor. You are looking at their strength and their weaknesses so that you know what to do. Ano yung gagawin mong strategy para malampasan yung strength nila and at the same time take advantage of their weaknesses. Okay, so again, you have four. Okay, panglima yung competitive intelligence. You have your scanning, environmental monitoring, environmental forecasting, and you have assessing or scenario analysis. Okay? Identify opportunities and threats is an important objective of studying general environment. And of course, that is very important. When you talk about opportunity, these are external factors or condition that may provide advantage to the company and will help the company achieve strategic competitiveness. Okay? Example, you have your Procter & Gamble is reorienting beauty products to better serve both men and women. Okay? They are reorienting beauty products. They are having an opportunity para mas makabenta or para mas lumawak yung market nila or the market share itself. And of course, you have to identify and take note also of the threats which may hinder the company in achieving their strategic competitiveness. Let us say Microsoft, they experience severe external threats such as the smartphones, and they are expected to surpass personal computers already. Diba? You already have your smartphone, so bakit mo pa kailangan ng PC or ng laptop? More or less, kung okay na yung phone mo at kayang-kaya niyang gawin lahat ng functions, kahit pa nga mag-encode, di ba? Tapos ang kailangan mo na lang, let's say, Bluetooth na keyboard, tapos makaka-encode ka na. Hindi mo na kailangan ng computer or ng laptop. And of course, at the same time, kung mataas yung memory ng phone mo, no problem. Okay? Hanap ka na lang ng Bluetooth na keyboard. Di ba uso na yun ngayon? Ayan. So that is for your opportunities and threats, I should say, instead of strength. Of course, the firm used several sources to analyze general environment, pwedeng trade publication, newspaper, business publication, academic researches. Uso pa rin naman yan ngayon kahit papano. You have public polls, yung mga polls na nakikita natin. Of course, you have the trade shows. Dito mo ma-observe ang general environment, supplier, customer, employees, and of course, over the internet. Ano bang meron ngayon? At saka yung news, di ba? Global news, you have your business news, dyan mo makikita yung, or dyan ka makakakuha ng items or information in order to analyze general environment. Okay? So, meron ka lang dito sa PPT natin na mga additional information regarding the scanning of your general environment. And of course, for monitoring, forecasting, and of course, assessing. Again, ang key mo lang dito, tandaan mo yung ni-lecture or yung discussion natin kanina. And of course, ito yung application nila. All right. Now we go to your industry factors or industry environment. Yung industry environment mo, again, kasali yan sa competitive environment, which includes your industry and your competitive environment per se. When you talk about industry, it is a group of firms that produce similar products and offer similar services that are close substitute. Meaning, let us say si Jollibee, okay? Pupunta ka kay Jollibee, okay? So, instead na ikaw yung customer ni Jollibee, kaso nakita mo, sobrang haba nung pila or queuing sila sa lahat ng counter nila, okay? Ang ginawa mo, lumipat ka kay McDo. Eh si McDo, meron din naman siyang spaghetti o kaya naman si fried chicken. So, imbis na pumasok ka kay Jollibee at makipila sa napakahabang pila, okay? Doon sa industry, meron naman si McDo kasi meron siyang close substitute dun sa ino-offer ni Jollibee. Meron namang spaghetti at saka fries at saka fried chicken si McDo. So yun yung tinutukoy natin regarding industry. Meaning, in the industry environment or this environment, meron kang other groups or other firms that are producing or they serve similar service or product. Okay? In terms of accounting firm, let us say you have SGV, KPMG, you have your PwC. Ngayon, they serve similar services. However, your basis is their price. Okay? Meaning, it's up to the customer na mag-decide kung ano or kung kanino siya kukuha ng bookkeeping service niya. Okay? Pwedeng dahil they are close substitute naman, magiging basis niya yung price. So ngayon, papasok dito ngayon yung power ng customer natin. Okay? So that's part of your industry. Now, compared to general environment, the industry environment has more direct effect on the firm. Okay? It is on the strategic competitiveness and on the ability to earn above average return. So, mas malaki yung effect or mas close yung effect ng industry environment natin compared sa general environment. Kasi unang-una si general environment, it is uncontrollable, di ba? And it is inherent to the presence of the firm in that specific environment or in the industry. Whereas dito sa industry factors natin, mas magkakaroon tayo ng control, mas makakaya nating i-manage or i-handle what type of strategy or what strategy we can do so that mas malakas tayo ngayon compared to our competitors as well as to direct competitors, okay? An industry's profit potential is a function of the five forces of your competition. These five forces of competition is called your Porter's five forces model. Let us write it down. Porter's five forces of model. Okay? Of industry, of course. It is a tool for examining the industry level competitive environment, especially the ability of the firm in that industry to set prices and minimize the cost. Okay? Again, your five Porter's model focuses or is a tool for examining the industry level competitive environment, especially the ability of the firm in the industry to set prices and minimize your cost. Okay? So, ano ba yung mga functions niyan or ano yung mga forces? Number one, you have threats to new entrants. Meaning, kapag merong mga bagong pasok sa market, there are possibility that the profit of the established firm may be eroded by the new competitor. Meaning, possible na mahatak nila yung market mo na meron ka ngayon. So, instead of having a 25% market share, magiging 22% market share kasi yung 3% hinatak ng new entrants. Next, you have your power of buyers. Unahin natin si power of buyers. This is also called your bargaining power of your buyers. The power of your buyer of the or the bargaining power of the buyer. Dito naman sa bargaining power of the buyer, the threat that the buyer may force down the prices. Meaning, they bargain for higher quality or more service and they play competitor against each other. Okay? They play competitor against each other. Meaning, itong bargaining power ni buyer mo, yan yung magiging competitor mo or yan yung magiging threat mo. Okay? In the competition. So, parang yun yung competitor mo instead na si other firm. Anong nangyayari? Gusto ni buyer mo, ibigay mo sa kanya or i-offer mo sa kanya yung quality product mo at a lower price. Okay? And ang hirap naman gawin yan. Or, ang mangyayari, mapipilitan ka. Kasi instead na bumili sa iba si buyer, di ba, at least sa'yo siya bibili, but at a lower price. Next one is the power of the supplier. This is also called the bargaining power of supplier naman. Dito sa bargaining power of the supplier, it is the threat that the supplier may raise their prices or reduce the quality of the purchased good or service. Okay? Dito sa threat na ito, bargaining power of the supplier, dalawa lang ang option nila dyan. It's either they provide you the same quality material at a higher price or bibigay nila sa iyo yan at the same price pero at a lower quality. Okay? But this is also risky kasi kung kukunin mo yung produkto ni supplier at the same price pero low quality, makakompromise naman ngayon yung product na gagawin mo or yung service na gagawin mo. So you have to be careful. Next, you have your product substitute or substitute product or services. Hindi lang product ha, pwede din yung services. Okay? In the substitute product or services, meaning there are product or service outside the industry that serve the same customer needs as the industry's product and services. Meaning, kung ano yung kailangan ni customer mo, napaprovide ng substitute product or service in other industry or in other firm. And of course, lastly, you have intensity of rivalry among competitors. It is talking about the threat that a customer will switch to their business, will switch their business to competitors within the industry. Meaning, di ba, interconnected to minsan sa product substitute. Instead of buying from entity A, I will buy from entity B. Bakit? Number one, preferences ko. Number two, factors na galing kay entity A. Okay? So that is talking about the intensity of the rivalry among the competitors. And of course, strategies are chosen in part because of the influence of the industry's characteristic and that is true. So bago ka mag-strategize, dapat alam mo muna or dapat may information ka talking about the industry. And of course, all those five forces or the Porter's forces are equally weighed. Meaning, dapat equally na i-test mo yung mga yan or i-check mo isa-isa in order for you to create a successful strategy. Okay? So, you just have here some of the informations na pinagsasabi ko kanina. Only that nag-stick kasi ako dun sa slide ko kanina. Okay? So, you have here on your PowerPoint or on your handouts as well, yung mga examples natin. So, idagdag lang natin itong economies of scale kasi wala siya kanina. When you say economies of scale, this is talking about the decrease in cost per unit as absolute output per unit increases. Okay? And it improves the efficiency that the firm will experience. That is your economies of scale. Of course, papasok din dito si product differentiation natin, and that is the degree that the product has a strong brand loyalty or customer loyalty. Okay? Meaning, you have a unique product, your customer can be loyal to you kasi nga product differentiation ka. Anong best example natin dyan? Your Apple products. Okay? Your Apple products definitely provide a product differentiation in the market. And of course, kapag may new entrants, most likely, they will offer low prices para instead na bumili kay Apple, bibili siya kay kanino. Let us say, kay Cherry Mobile. Diba? Napansin mo si Cherry Mobile, super cheap. Tapos, yung mga design niya, just like the designs of your Oppo or the Vivo. Diba? Similar lang. Ngayon, sino pa rin na mas powerful? If you have product differentiation, powerful pa rin si Apple. Bakit kahit 64,000 yung Apple 11 Pro Max, bibilin at bibilin pa rin ni customer. Bakit? Maganda kasi Apple, di ba? Kasi kunyari feeling rich ako, mukha akong rich, okay? And of course, there are features na unique dun kay Apple 11 Pro Max, okay? Kaya ko siya binili. That is your product differentiation. And of course, you have your capital requirements. Ito, depende na to ngayon sa company as well. And of course, it differs according to industry. Depende naman kung saang industry ka kasali. Next, switching cost. Ito yung isa sa mga additionals natin. One-time cost customer incur when they buy from different supplier. Okay? Like your new equipment, retraining employees, psychological cost of ending a supplier relationship. Ito yung shifting. Kung kanino ka initially bumibili, and ngayon papalitan mo. Parang ikaw, supplier mo si A, ngayon supplier mo na si B. So actually, your handout or this PPT is very long, but I'm only tackling the important points, okay? So of course, on your side, pwede mong basahin yung mga yan. But in our topic, I'm only focusing on the important points, but also, we provided informations here that can help you on your review. Next, ang haba kasi nito eh, di ba? Kung iisa-isahin ko to, hindi ko na natapos yung presentation ko sa'yo. Kaya, ginawa kong minsanan yung binigay ko kanina habang nakapresent siya ng buo, the five model or the Porter's five model. Okay? So, okay na tayo sa industry rivalry mo. You also have your exit buyers, meaning you prevent competitors from leaving the industry. Okay? Maganda to kapag okay yung competition, meaning okay ka naman in terms of the market share. You have no problems. Okay. Actually, part of our discussion is your SWOT analysis. But let's have that on a separate discussion or separate session or video, I should say. What else do we need to talk about regarding your external environment? Punta na tayo ngayon sa ating Strategic groups, okay? So you have here your strategic groups, meaning this is a set of firm emphasizing similar strategic dimension and using similar strategies, okay? Yung strategic group, you have your infrastrategic, and this is more intense than interstrategic group. So the competition within a strategic group is greater than the competition between strategic group, okay? And there is more heterogeneity in the performance of the firm within the strategic groups. So you have the different strategic dimensions. You have the extent of technological leadership, product quality, pricing policies, distribution channels, and customer services. So ano yung mga implication yan? Meaning, the firm within a strategic group are direct competitor, meaning let us say si Jollibee and McDo, they are direct competitors. So si Jollibee and McDo. What else? Yung mga milky shops mo na yan. You have your Zenty, Macau Imperial, you have your Tea Hive, and kung ano-ano pa. They are direct competitors because most likely they use the same strategy on how they sell or they market their product. And of course, the strength of the five supporters, forces differ across the strategic groups. Yung five forces, nagtitrigger sila or nagtitrigger yon ng differences among the strategic groups. And of course, the closer the strategic group in terms of strategy, the greater the likelihood the rivalry. Siyempre, kung ang strategy ng isa mag-food panda, tapos nag-food panda din yung isa, di ba? Siyempre, mas malakas or mas malaki or greater yung rivalry between them. Imagine mo yung customer nag-i-scroll sa Food Panda tapos, oops, kanino kaya? Kay Zenty or kay Tea Hive? Oops, kanino kaya? Kay Macau Imperial or kay Gongcha? O, di ba? Yan yung mga items na yan. Okay? And of course, competitor intelligence, nabanggit natin to kanina. Ano nga ulit yung competitor intelligence mo? Your competitor intelligence is talking about your competitive advantage pa yung sinabi ko kanina, competitive environment pala. O iba pala tong competitor intelligence, sorry. So when you say competitor intelligence, these are the set of data or information na nakuha ng competitor mo and they understand it better than you, okay? And anticipate competitors' objectives, strategies, assumptions, and capabilities. So itong competitor intelligence, they are gathered information, okay? So that they can better understand their rival or their competitor. Like, let us say you have Zenty and you have Tea Hive. Ngayon, si Tea Hive, nag-gather siya ng data information. Ano bang ginagawa ni Zenty? Ano ba yung mga ino-offer ni Zenty, di ba? Mayroon ba siyang promo? Hahanapin niya yan ngayon. Pwedeng mag-observe siya. Okay? Ngayon, that is to better understand the competitor so that they know how to anticipate the rivalry or the competition in the market. Ano yung magiging approach nila? Okay? Na kung napansin mo, si Zenty, wala yata siya sa Food Panda. Okay? I just don't know kung nag-register na siya. But, lately kasi or dati kasi I order Tea Hive, 'di ba? I order Tea Hive. Ngayon hinahanap ko si Zenty kasi originally nung wala pa yung Food Panda kay Zenty ako nagpupunta. However, walang Zenty. Ngayon tumingin ako ng ibang brand na cheaper pero masarap naman. So nakita ko si Tea Hive. Ngayon, si Tea Hive and Zenty, anong competitive advantage ni Tea Hive? Nandun siya sa Food Panda. So, kung i-compare mo, possible na mas malaki market share ni Tea Hive kesa kay Zenty. Kasi nasa Food Panda siya. Eh, si Zenty masarap sana. Kaso, di ba? Ba't kasi wala siya sa Food Panda? Ayan, yon. So, inaral nila yung mga behavior ng competitors nila. Ngayon, si Zenty, kapag nakita niya na, ay lahat yata ng tea house, di ba? Yung mga nag-o-offer ng milk tea, nasa Food Panda na, ako na lang yung wala. Ngayon, magre-register din siya. Okay? So, that is your competitor intelligence. How can your competitor gather information from you? It's either Number one, meron tayo niyan eh. Number one, trespassing. Diba? Uy, may isang employee si Zenti pumunta kay T-Hive. Tinitingnan niya, ano bang ginagawa kaya ni T-Hive? Bakit ang laki-laki or ang dami-daming bumibili sa kanila? Okay? Ano ginawa niya? Nag-trespassing siya. Or pumunta siya doon sa area ni T-Hive. Tapos nag-spy pa. So, para din siyang spy dito sa area na to. What else? Eavesdrop. Okay? Nagda-dine in yung customer ni Zenti. Habang nag-uusap yung customer ni Zenti na rinig niya, parang si T-Hive tsaka si Zenti yung pinag-uusapan. You do eavesdropping. So, that's how you do unethical tactics. However, unethical tong mga to, ah, di ba? In your information gathering. What else? Blackmail. Ay, ito naman ang pinakapangit, di ba? Bablackmailin mo yung competitor mo, di ba? Legal siyang gumagawa ng business, tapos ikaw ngayon na hindi mo alam mag-strategize, ibablackmail mo, di ba? Next, is stealing drawing samples or document. Ito naman yung pinakamasaklap kasi, syempre, may sariling menu at saka may sariling, let us say, may sariling, anong tawag neto? Recipe, si T-Hive. Tapos, anong ginawa ni Zenti? Nanakawin niya, kukunin niya, gagayahin niya para sa kanya bumili si customer. That is part of your unethical tactics, okay? So, balikan natin yung nakapresent kanina. You have what you call your complementors. Your complementors are the network of company that sell complementary products or that are compatible with the local firm's own product. Meaning, kung meron kang, let us say, milk at meron kang tea, pwede mong pagsamahin, meron ka ng milk tea. Diba? Medyo literal, pero totoo naman. Yan yung ibig sabihin ng complementors natin. Okay? Kung meron kang spaghetti, dapat meron kang chicken joy. Okay? Para mas masarap ang kain. So, hindi ibig sabihin na pag bumili ako ng spaghetti, hindi na ako bibili ng chicken joy. Ang ibig sabihin, pag bumili ako ng spaghetti, mas masarap kung may chicken joy. Meaning, they are complementary. Okay? Your complementor, hindi mo siya competitor, ha? Ang complementor mo, ibig sabihin, kung bibili ako ng cake ko, dapat meron din akong ice cream. Okay? Ibig sabihin, it goes together. So, that's your complementor. Si competitor, ang ibig sabihin yan, kung bibili ako ng cake, kanino kaya ako bibili? Kay Goldilocks or kay Red Ribbon? Yun yung ibig niyang sabihin dyan. Let us say, merong Black Forest si Goldilocks. Merong Black Forest si Red Ribbon. Kanino ba ako bibili? Diba? Alin yung mas masarap? Ibig sabihin, there are substitute. Now, what are the other possibilities na pwedeng kay competitor siya pumunta? Ang hinahanap ni customer, Black Forest. Pumunta siya kay Red Ribbon, walang Black Forest. Pero di ba meron namang Goldilocks? So, kay Goldilocks siya bumili, di ba? Na kay competitor ngayon yung sale o kaya yung market share at this point in time. Kasi nandun yung Black Forest, wala na kay Red Ribbon out of stock. That is your competitor. They provide substitute product. Yung isa complementor, meaning it complements your product. So, that ends our presentation in terms of your external already. Meron pa ba akong idadagdag? Natakal naman na nating lahat. I just wanted to add how the internet and digital technologies affect the five competitive forces. Yung Porter's model mo kanina. Number one, the internet. Ano ulit ang internet? That is the global network of linked computers that use common transmission format, exchange information, and store data. They already affect your five Porter's model already. What else? Using the industry analysis, there is a few caveats. You have number one, your zero-sum game. So, aside from the complements na pinag-usapan natin kanina, meron ka pang zero-sum game. Isulat ko lang para mas maintindihan mo. Zero sum, walang letter E ha, erase natin yung letter E. Zero sum game. What is zero sum game? It is a situation in which multiple players interact and winners win only by taking from other players. Okay? Again, your zero-sum game is a situation where a multiple player interact and then the winner will win only by taking from other players. Kasama niya si complements. Okay, so si complement natakal natin kanina. You also have your strategic group within the industries. Natakal na din natin kanina. Your strategic group, again, they are the cluster of firms that share similar strategies. Okay? All right. So, that is the end. So, to summarize, your managers, of course, must analyze the external environment to minimize or eliminate threats and exploit opportunities. Of course, this will involve continuous process of environmental scanning and monitoring, as well as obtaining competitive intelligence on present and potential rivals. These activities will provide valuable inputs for developing forecasts. In addition, many firms use scenario planning to anticipate and respond to volatile and disruptive environment changes. So our environment is a very large factor in creating and innovating a company strategy, okay? So kailangan mong i-identify yung mga factors na makaka-affect sa'yo. Number one, general environment, and number two, industry environment. And don't forget your five quarters model kasi nakaka-apekto yan in terms of your industry factors, okay? Now, I wanted to see you on our next video. We will tackle about your SWOT analysis.